Hey guys, welcome back to Holly Scoops Just Saying. I'm Heather Gardner.
I'm Stephanie Gray.
Okay, we have so much drama to talk about today, and I just feel like perhaps the next biggest, most high schoolish, most immature celebrity feud is like on the surface. It kind of makes me happy, and on one level, I'm like, what is going on here? You want to tell them who it is?
Between Justin Bieber and the one-sided feud turned into a two-sided feud now that The Weeknd has clapped back.
We had talked about this last week on another show about how Justin kind of keeps poking, but The Weeknd was being classy and
saying nothing.
Class is done. He is finished. Why don't you just tell them what he said today?
Okay, well, he clapped back, literally attacking Bieber's manhood, which I believe is the biggest, in the world of men, I think that's like the biggest insult that you can get. For girls, it's like, you're ugly, but for guys, it's like, you're bad in bed, your penis is small. Like, that's the stuff
and
they care about.
And that's how low he stooped today with Justin. Now, just in case you need a reminder, the reason they're having this feud is because once upon a time, Justin and Selena dated. That ended terribly. And now Selena has moved on to The Weeknd. Justin has been not so graciously talking about The Weeknd.
He does a new jab every week. If he's not talking about the fact that The Weeknd's music is whack, then he's laughing with his friends, sarcastically making fun of one of The Weeknd's hit songs. I mean, he's always going after it, and I feel like Selena Gomez does the same thing to him whenever he's dating someone like Sophia Richie, and then she gets involved. So both of them do that. But up to this point, we thought The Weeknd was like
staying
above
it
all. Yeah. No.
Not at all.
No.
And this is hilarious because like as soon as I read this story today, Lee, she loves it. She loves
he
the drama.
He ain't classy. No one is classy. Everyone stoop real low like they in high school.
Is that a new rap that you're putting out? You heard it here first, the exclusive Stephanie Gray rap. Okay, it's funny because we had talked about this in on a different video, like we said, and the comments were like, oh my gosh, like this is so immature, like these, you know, and I was like, no, I was defending them. I was like, they're adults, they know. And at this point, I'm like, yeah, you're right. Like this is so immature of them, especially, it seems like high school to me, and they're all in their 20s.
It seems premeditated. So The Weeknd has been quiet this whole time, but secretly, he's known, I'm sure, that he'd be collaborating with his rapper friend guy. Mm-hmm. So his rapper friend releases this new track, okay? And then The Weeknd has a line in the track, and the line basically says, I don't remember it exactly, but the song is about stealing another guy's girl, okay? And
hello!
And then his line is something about how he is the remedy for Selena Gomez, because Bieber was so bad in bed, and she really likes his F-U-C-K-ing and his like tongue.
Gosh.
That was essentially.
Ew. I mean,
he was there.
Rap is not my genre of music that I generally listen to.
No,
anyway,
Adele
but
is. We know this.
Yes,
and Carrie Underwood.
Oh yes, but like I'm just like that makes me not want to stay away even more. Like,
but doesn't that make you think it's premeditated though? Because that he hasn't said anything, but he must have known he'd be doing a verse on that song.
And here is what makes me like almost, I'm kind of getting tired of this drama, to be honest. Again, for the premeditation, but also for Selena. If you watched this show a few months ago when Selena was like coming back from rehab and like, oh yeah, she's so strong, she's so powerful, womanhood, I just am kind of losing my respect for her just a little bit. Because you're right, she totally claps back at Justin. That was all, got their feud lasted forever. Then she had to go away to rehab, and now she comes back and she proclaims she's gonna have this new life, but then she goes right back into it.
I know, but I'm actually starting to think, okay? And tell me what you guys think, but I'm starting to think that she really is into The Weeknd, just because she spent 30 grand on his birthday
that
she wasn't even at. That's real money, okay?
Apparently, for her, like that's like a drop in the cup for her.
But like rumors are circulating now that they might be moving in together, that she's saving money for that, and that she's talking to a realtor. So I'm starting to hear all these things. Oh, she went to a lingerie store and bought lingerie before their sexy yacht trip. So I'm just saying, it seems like she's putting all her eggs in that basket.
Yeah, but I'm just like, if she really, really, really wanted to heal from herself, wouldn't she date just a normal guy? Like, and would she tell The Weeknd, like, hey, babe, this is serious. Like, let's not worry about my childish ex-boyfriend.
No, they're both immature, so they belong together. It makes perfect sense.
Oh, it makes perfect sense,
It makes perfect sense.
Okay,
yes.
Guys.
She's probably proud of him. Like, good job. Way to go for the manhood, babe. Way to go,
Way to go there. See, and that makes me hate her. I don't want to hate her. I want to like her. Okay, but now we're going to have to hear from you.
Yes.
Like, do you think this is just going to be the biggest, like, celebrity feud of the year so much? I mean, we're only February. She says yes. Also, are you kind of... I'm just feeling like it's so immature of these people. Like, is that what you guys are feeling too?
That never stopped anyone, just saying.
Just saying. Let us know in the comment section down below. Leave us your comments, subscribe to our channel, and we will see you next time with even more drama.
Mwah. Bye, guys.
Bye-bye.